To be honest, I don't know how I just spent 400 hours or more in this game and I never knew about this weapon. And yes, I have a pretty high level, I know a lot of secrets, I did most of the game on my channel, I have over 500 videos with this game on my channel, but I never knew about this one. Let me tell you, no, this is not the one. The one that I am talking about is this beautiful, I don't even know the name of this weapon. It's a great weapon, it's pretty heavy, it has probably not the highest damage, definitely up there in the top, but the thing that is very, very good about this weapon is that you can inflict a large damage from a distance, and it can keep your enemy on the ground. So basically you can, bro, this is so good. You can keep your enemies to the ground just by casting the skill of the weapon. Easy as that. And let me tell you, it can pierce to armor very, very good. Probably one of my favorite weapons at this moment, and I have a lot of those. Again, I don't know how I just missed it in my first gameplay, when I just first finished the game. Now, let me just show what it can do to a dog. Obviously, in this video, I'm going to show how you can get it, the full tutorial, the complete tutorial. Just look how that dog just will stay on the ground. Not this one, because this one, there were two dogs. Yep. Just look at that. But let me explain you even better with this bird. You know how aggressive is this type of bird if you play the game. And just look how it's just sitting there. Not even a move. I absolutely love. And the regular attack that you just saw right now, it's huge. It's huge. And it's on only level 9. You can make it level 10. So let's start. This will be a magical weapon, so you can upgrade it with Somber Smithing Stone. From the first step, you have to reach the Mount Gelmir. That's it. I'm going to show you in this video how you can do that, but I have a full tutorial of how you can be to the Mount Gelmir if this is too fast for you. Basically, reach the Grand Lift of Dectus. Here you're going to have to use the Medallion of Dectus, left and right. I have a video on my channel how you can get that medallion if you don't have it. From the Forest Spinning Great Bridge, you're going to be teleported right over here. And just take this road that I'm going to show you right now on the map. I'm going to show you every single site of grace that you have to be on. Basically, the road that you have to take, you can go right over here and under that bridge. And keep going until you're gonna find this Bridge of Iniquity. Really easy to reach the Bridge of Iniquity, that's why we're gonna start from this location. Everything is gonna be just a little bit on fast forward, not that fast, so you can still follow me. And you're gonna see a ladder that you can really easily miss right here on the left. So be sure not to miss this ladder, because it's very important. This is gonna take you up to that Mount Gelmir. You're gonna see those enemies that are just trying to follow you every step of the way, but don't mind them. And yes, we have to defeat an enemy. Let me again, I never lie on my videos. I don't want to make a shock something, I don't know, like the best weapon. Definitely, in my opinion, this is in top 5 weapons in the game, the one that you're about to take. But let me tell you something else. The enemy that you're about to fight right now, for me, was pretty hard. And I'm level 220. I died once, so good luck. I'm going to explain how you can defeat that enemy. But you know what? Let's just find it first. Take every single site of grace that you're going to see in this video. And you're going to pass this pumpkin head. If you are seeing that pumping head, you are in the perfect place. And then right over here, you want to make on this ladder, just climb. It will be a scion right there. It will appear, but you don't have to stay and fight that scion. You don't want to have more trouble. You just want to have to get that sword. That's it. Sword is not a sword. It's a claw with a magical ability with a huge damage. The skill is huge, the skill damage is huge, the regular attack is huge, and I told you, mine is level 9, you can upgrade it to level 10, because it's a magical item. You cannot upgrade it with smithing stones, only with somber stones. Now, let's just go up right here. Here is gonna be a merchant if you want to buy something that most of the players don't know about. If you are new, obviously. If you are an expert, I know. You know everything. Now let's just climb. Don't have to stay to fight those enemies. Again, just follow me. Now you can grab your horse. Go on this bridge on the left. And you're gonna see the last sight of Grace. Definitely want to take this one, because this one is gonna be very, very important. After you're gonna take the sight of Grace, here is gonna start the battle. This will, for me, is the second battle, because I told you I died first time. And let me explain how I defeat this guy. First things first, very fast. While you are on your horse, not like me, you can just summon your best spirit. For me, is the Mimic Tear or a Black Teach Knife. If you don't have those spirits, I have videos on my channel how you can get them. I have videos on my channel how you can get most of the summon spirits. Just take this Mimic Tear if you have it. Basically, it will be a copy of you. For me, that is very strong. And then I just try to defeat this guy with more weapons. Let me tell you something that I noticed that it's working. First things first, you can use a magical weapon with a good skill like this one, the Blasphemous Sword, or the, if you are in the New Game Plus, you already have the Sacred Relic Sword, the one that you're gonna see me using. And also, if you have a strong Mimic Tear that can tank a lot of your hits and it's a good level, you can stay far away from this guy and just cast the best spells that you have. I have a lot of good spells on my channel if you don't know how to get them, or the best incantations. This is definitely not the best one for me and for this boss, but I just try to defeat this guy with a sword after that. The Blasphemous Sword basically is gonna give me some HP back, but I'm gonna consume a lot of FP points. And then from time to time I also use the Wave of Gold, which will be the Sacred Relic Sword. Again, if you didn't finish the game, you cannot have the sword, so you have to finish the game in order to get the sword. But there are a lot of good weapons out there. I have videos, more than 50 videos only with swords, because in this game I have a lot of videos, but only with swords I have a lot of those. Now just keep attacking him, because this is one of the most aggressive bosses that I found here in this game. Not the strongest, but one of the most aggressive. Lucky for me, I got lucky with my Mimic Tear, because yeah, that guy, my copy, just took a lot of hits. I just defeat this guy, and just let me show you what you're gonna get. Really important, a Somber Smithing Stone level 6, a Smithing Stone level 6, and the Falling Star Beast Jaw. So that will be the name of the weapon. Let me show you what I had on me. Not the best armor, just for looks I just took the armor. I have stronger armors in my inventory, and these are the talisman that I used. That Dragon Crest Shield talisman is very, very good. Now let me showcase the weapon, because it's very important to show you some stats. This is how it looks. Pretty awesome. One of the most crazy looking weapons in the game. And these are the stats. It will build up with some dexterity, strength, and intelligence. But you have to have... It will be very, very heavy. As I just told you, it has a really good regular attack. But the skill is just insane. Now, I never knew at the beginning, I didn't know how to use it, but let me tell you. You can use this from a safe distance, like I'm about to show you right now, with this giant. Just look at that. I'm from a safe distance, and my second hit just nailed that guy to the ground. Sorry if my English is not perfect, it's my second language, so I hope you can understand me. After that, everything was a piece of cake, because just... It cannot be near me, because I just keep him on the ground. Kneel, bro, kneel. Now, let me show you what it can do to a knight with a heavy armor. Just look at that, and look at the distance that I'm to that guy. Yep, you just saw right. 3 hits and all 4, and it's on the ground. And my build is not around this weapon, let me tell you from the start. I'm a warrior. I have some strength, but I have the points all over the place. I'm not built for something, I don't know, specific. At least I can use it, so for me it's enough. The skill name of the weapon is the Gravity Bolt. And okay, let's see that guy. I just wanted to test the distance that you can use this weapon from. And here let's see what it can do to a pile of enemies, not only more than one enemy right here. Just insane. I absolutely love the weapon. I wanted to test it with so many enemies because in my opinion this will be the boss killer. I already defeat one boss with this one, with this weapon. Too bad I didn't record, but definitely other mini boss that I defeat, that was that knight. I'm gonna show you in this video right now. Yes, I defeated a knight that it's at the beginning of the game, a very heavy one, and I just keep putting to the ground. But you have to learn a little bit to use the weapon, to learn how to dodge, when to strike, and definitely you can build your armor, everything around this weapon, and you can make it way much better than mine. Just look what I did to this poor bird. This is again a very aggressive enemy that cannot move because this is so strong and so good. Trust me, if you have trouble with some bosses, with some enemies that you cannot defeat, you should try this one. Probably it will work. But let me remind you, this thing, it's pretty heavy, so you need to wear a light armor if you don't have enough of endurance. That was the regular attack, and let me show you what I just did to this knight. Again, I never know how to dodge in this game, so I just got some hits. But when I started to attack the enemy, bro, the easiest fight with a knight like this. Again, I have to learn how to dodge the hits. That's it. Thank you so much for watching. Tell me if you like this weapon, if you knew about it. You know I always read your comments, I always answer to your comments. See you in the next one, be safe, and yeah, you can hit the notification bell. That it's the most important thing if you don't want to miss the next video that I'm gonna post. Bye.